Hello, and today I'm going to show you just how quickly I put together topical maps using ChatGPT for my site's client sites in order to help them expand their content exactly in the way that Google wants to see it, exactly for the things that their users want to read, so they can get more leads, more traffic, and more sales for their businesses. Fantastic. I'm going to try to do this in under 34 minutes, 11 a.m. sharp. The construction workers in the unit above mine will start drilling holes, and it will be impossible to record, meaning you should also be able to put it together in just about half an hour. Sounds good? Let's go. Let's get us started. First off, concentration. Brain FM does not sponsor this video, but I wish they did. And let's put a little timer on the screen. Boom, bam, minglava, let's go. All right, so first off, who is the case? It's a real business. It's a immigration consultant. In Canada, they help people move to Canada, get it all sorted nice and legal and clean, okay? Have fantastic reviews, and I chatted with them. They wanted to do better with their SEO, but it's a brand new site, right? So I thought, well, listen, you're gonna need some content first, okay? How do I do it? Keywords, you can't really base anything on the keywords that they have, but we know they wanna rank for immigration consultant. So let's go and drop this here. Oh, I cheated, sorry, I already had this loaded. Ah, my bad. Anyway, Canadian immigration consultant, all right? And this is what we want to find here. Yeah, cheated because I wanted to show you this. So you want to go and open the main sites already ranking for whatever it is that yourself or your client wants to rank as the most important thing. Okay, I'm going to open a bunch. And then you do drop them. Ah, this is an official site. This might be difficult if you're ranking for too many things. Okay, and then you do drop them on this kind of overview, okay? And the whole point of doing that is so you can get some inspiration to see what others are ranking for. Okay, 76 keywords, that's not very great. What if we do worldwide? Mr. Worldwide, let's see. Okay. Aha, so they seem to rank for a lot of stuff in the Philippines. Okay, what do they do? Mediation consultant in Canada, yeah, great, not useful. Okay, Canada agency in the Philippines, okay, that's a good one. Right, so what I'm trying to show you here, what I go through here is through a basic layer of research to try to understand, you know, what's the ACP, who do they help, right? And what kind of keywords do a broader range of competitors rank for? So if Canada agency in the Philippines or legit Canadian agency in the Philippines are basically immigrating to Canada from the Philippines, which I understand is what this would be about, right? That's what these people do exist, therefore more countries must exist. This looks too legit. Canada immigration, cool. Let's look at these guys. Right? So now we have, okay. Yeah. Philippines, so we have countries. Let's see what they're offering Canada, these guys. Yeah, just consultants, visa consultants. How many, what was it? How to be an immigration consultant. Okay, so the meta question. How express entry works. Okay. Not very useful. Fingerprint services, whatever. Family sponsorship. Okay, so basically different ways, right, to go as a family sponsorship or CSE sponsorship. Okay, that's good. That's useful. Let's see what these guys rank for. All I'm getting here is ideas. Don't skip this part for the sake of being fast. Okay, that's what will actually make you fast, you will see. This is the record. What language is this? How to apply for visitor record, immigration consultant fees. Okay, so how much is it gonna cost? Interesting. Okay, Turkey from Canada. That will, well, it probably also works the other way around. Okay, so how to immigrate to Canada from Turkey, I get it. Visitor record form, okay. So, okay, what is this? Extension visas, I get it. I mean, I immigrated multiple times in my life, so I kind of get already an idea, right? Never to Canada, but you know, so I kind of get an idea of already. Okay, how much do they charge for this? Moving with your family, okay, good. And now let's pop somebody else to see what other keywords they rank for. And then you'll see why I spent here 5 minutes just looking at random keywords and how I do it with ChatGPT. What is this? CIB, what's this? Oh, language test. Okay, language test. Okay, cool. I think I got enough. So that last guy. Got language, countries, another country. Processing time, human capital, okay. Updates, employer requirements, okay. Okay. Requirements for employers, jobs. Right, okay. So then, using this as some quick ideas, and I think I missed one of the guys actually, but that's fine. Then we're gonna come here and we're gonna start asking questions like a human being would do to ChatGPT. ChatGPT is gonna give us all the information and then we're just gonna ask it to do it for our website. So let's say, what are the most popular countries from question mark. It's gonna give us some information. Okay, cool. I just need a list. Cool. So it's gonna spit out the list. And now what we're gonna say, okay. I'm checking my little cheat sheet of questions. It'll be somewhere in a little document, okay? And why am I asking for this query string? Because I'm an SEO and I know how to structure keywords, right? But like, if you don't know, like, well, you need to think like how a user would ask this question, right? So I'm an immigration consultant. I serve people from, let's say, Brazil, right? So immigrate to Canada from Brazil. If I was in Brazil and I was on the other side of the equation, that's probably how I put it together, right? Then who else would be going, right? This is the people that we're addressing. So it's gonna be professionals, it's gonna be students. Most common professions of people who migrate to Canada. Let's see what it says. Beautiful. Very fast as well, okay? List them all as a query. String. How would I frame this? How to? So if I am a sales associate, or you know, I'm an accountant, I'm a certified accountant, or I'm a nurse, right? Like a physician, and I want to move to Canada. Like, okay, you know, I went to school for God knows how many years. The question would be like, how do I transfer my paperwork as a nurse to maybe get the same certification in Canada? Do I have to go to certain exams, etc., right? So an article like that. What else will people face? Well, we saw, obviously, healthcare. Let's just ask, what are the most common? Let's see what ChatGPT says. So the idea here, right, is we just make humane questions to ChatGPT. We extract as much information as we can around the niche. And then once it spit out the information, then we put the SEO brain on and we think, okay, then just give me this stuff as query strings. And then we're gonna get all the query strings and we're gonna ask it to chart it out for the website with good ontological hierarchy. And so we can get something that resembles a topical map, right? Okay, so family separation, stability, accident services. Yeah, okay. So yeah, credentials, beautiful. We knew this. Housing, of course, makes sense. Cultural adjustments, language barriers. Okay, so we saw in one of these keywords, right, that they needed to pass certain language tests. Makes sense. Of course, getting a job, accessing services like telecom and what you need now to get a phone number. Do you need a sponsor at the beginning? Can you just show up with a passport and just get a phone number? Okay. So list them out and then you give it an example, right? So what would be a good example? How to get nursing on the video. Let's see what it says. Okay. Now, if you like the list, then fine. But you can say, give me more. It's free. You just ask it for more. So realistically, right? Somebody's looking to migrate to the country. they will have all these questions, right? Some of them, you know, might not apply. If you don't have children, then you don't have to solve that, you know. But you might want to start a business, or you might want to, like, okay, what happens after I get PR? How can I get citizenship? So I'm asking, okay, let's see. Good, very good. Let's put it together. So it's gonna speed the whole thing out. So now we have our table. This starts to look good. Now I'm gonna ask it to start building us a URL structure. With that, we're gonna get the menu, we're gonna get where to put things together. So this is the prompt, okay? And let's see what it says. The idea is to cover this entire topical map, right? And then I'm gonna show you in a different video how to create this content very quickly, so that then the people running this business, they don't have to write it all from scratch. They can sit down with the articles and then just polish them, make sure that the information that is added on those is factual, right? They can make sure that whatever numbers and quotes and all these different things are correct, the processes, all these different things, right? Because what you don't want is to create content that is for a subject sensitive of this, right? Where if you get a step wrong, then you need to go back and bounce from different offices, so you can get your application denied or whatever, or waste a lot of money on consultation fees. The idea is that you can cover all these multiple points for free on your blog accurately, right? And as people do research, they might then struggle with one last step, right? Certain certification or certain something, right? But more and more people from the ICP will find this business, and some people will try to figure the entire thing on their own, and that's fine, that will always happen, right? Some people watching this video will want to do this entirely on their own, but then they might watch this video and 50 other videos, and they're like, you know what? I'm just gonna hire Alejandro to do it for me, right? Cool. And this is the same idea, right? While this goes, I'm gonna go and generate a Google Sheet to start slapping all of this on. So this ontology now, we're gonna call it parent category. Article title. For the person doing this, says, okay, I'm gonna create all these parent categories, you know, housing, cultural adjustment, language, employment. Now, you don't necessarily have to. If you wanna append everything to the root because you're lazy and you don't care about good hierarchy of content, that's fine, right? It's not as good as it could be. You can do more, right? Then you can go and go deeper into any of these. So I'm gonna show you, since I still have about 8 minutes before my lovely neighbors start drilling. Let's see what else we can ask to ChatGPT. Another good question that we can ask is, when doing this niche, what are the main challenges that ICP will face? Let's see what it says. Ideally, we'll be able to now create queries for all of these things. Okay, and you need to check your source. So this comes from the Government of Canada Immigration and Citizenship website, which is fantastic. So now the next prompt that we can throw here, let's see. We're just gonna ask you to do the same, okay? I'm asking. It's just so fast. And now we're just gonna ask it to put it all in a table, and we're gonna come here, and we're gonna continue expanding this, right? Very simple. Awesome. So same prompt, right? Extract the query strings in a table format. This is some hierarchy. Same URL, let's see what it says. We already have the title, we already have the keyword in the URL, okay, then we can have the page title, right? And then we have the three kings of on-page SEO covered. God bless, let's come here, let's just slap it here at the bottom. Maybe not this way, here. Over 100 articles, right, in 25 minutes that are exactly on point with no keyword research. And now the question, right? Let's do this quick check here. How many of these keywords does Ahrefs say that actually have search traffic? Now, I didn't base really any of this in keywords per se. I didn't extract keyword lists and dump them on all these different things. I got a scan through keywords to get an idea of the reality of the niche, to then ask questions to ChatGPT like a person, right? And a lot of this is gonna tell you that it's not even indexed, right? But I tell you, there's gonna be a lot of variations of this, okay? New immigrant in Canada, what to know, kind of keywords, right? That will apply. So even if this says, oh, apply for Canadian citizenship, and this has a 3,300 searches, I guarantee you if they create the entire topical map, the actual traffic that they will get is way bigger than this. So don't sleep in any of these like no search volume keywords, because I guarantee you the keyword immigrate to Canada from Pakistan will have search volume, right? You have here out of the global, it does appear, right? And a lot of this stuff that ASOS doesn't have in the database, they will have traffic, right? And it's the kind of stuff that matters. And with this, you cover the entire topical map. In the next video, I'll show you how to then go and dump this list here into one of my favorite, most affordable AI content creation tools that spits out content with lots of tables, formatted content, bullets, and so forth. So then you as an expert can go and review it and start creating your actual content on site. This was creating a topical map in less than 30 minutes. Thank you very much, and God bless.